I'm Aaron Fletcher.
I'm Christian Craig.
I'm Hunter Lawrence.
Josh Mode.
I'm Cameron McAdoo.
I'm Justin Brayton.
Hey, I'm Marvin Muskan.
I'm Malcolm Stewart.
I'm Jalen Ferrangis.
And I choose OGO.
I choose OGO.
I choose OGO.
I choose OGO.
Well, we did it. We did it as a team, as USA. It's been 11 years. It's been a long time. Probably too long. They don't come easy. This is my fourth attempt and fourth try, you know, to try to get as a team. So, and we all pulled our weight today, which was really cool. Justin rode great. Chase rode great. I had a really good first moto. We were really strong on Saturday in the qualifying races, and then of course the rain comes, right? And I'm just like, well, this could be the great equalizer. Normally the mud is, and it almost makes it more special that we're able to get it done with this condition in the rain, because so many things go wrong in a mud race, and our advantage kind of gets thrown out the window. So the fact that we were able to still win with this condition is a huge deal. So once again, yeah, just a rad day for the USA.
Looking at the day as a whole, like you guys did three laps on one bike, came back, switched.
Yeah.
A lot of little things that in the past had gotten overlooked. It seems like the strategy in the last 4 years has really stepped up. How did it feel for you as the guy that had been there that year and now this year? How has it shifted a bit? Is it a little bit more fluid like they've all wondered, or is it just like, hey, we got here, we had to do the job?
Well, it's the whole event just feels different. I mean, the whole start procedure is different. We were able to take two bikes up there. We were able to take a secondary bike for the hot lap with the mud. And then it's a totally different starting procedure. You know, mechanics can't get past the bar on the gate, right? So you have to set your own blocks. You have to line up your rear wheel by yourself. And it's, at first it's kind of relaxed. There's a lot of people up there. And then it's kind of like panic mode once you actually get up there to make sure everything's set and right. So you try not to let it throw you off, but it does feel a lot different than our normal summer series. So, yeah, didn't matter though. Pulled it through.
All right, how were those motos? Like, where were you at just going through it? You knew not the greatest starts, but
yeah.
Good guys in front of you, a nice little gap to always cut away. Was it fun, like motivating out there?
It was. The crowd was just totally crazy. Obviously, Moto 1 was Moto 1. I was able to rip the whole shot and just go. And then Geertz was close to me, but I was able to sneak away from him. And then Moto 2 had a decent start, but then I got pushed a little wide. I went a little wide into the first turn, and then I was kind of up in the mud and the muck and got spit out the back. Had to avoid a crash in turn 2, got kind of swallowed back. But at that point, it didn't matter. Chase was moving forward. Justin already put in the good scores. Yeah, man. That was it.
Hey, you were enjoying this weekend. I've never seen you have as much fun as you had from Friday to now. Congrats, dude. That was fun.
Yeah, it was a lot of fun. There's no sight like MXON on the podium looking down. It was crazy.
It was awesome. Pretty good weekend, even with all the weather, you know, involved. Saturday was really, really fun. Probably the most fun I've had racing in that qualifying race. And yeah, just brought the momentum at the Sunday. We knew it was going to rain, just a matter of how much, and it rained. When we showed up, it took a toll on the track, to say the least. Free practice was pretty gnarly, and knew we were in for a long, tough day. So I think we all, you know, with the conditions, we all stayed pretty consistent and pretty solid. So I thought that was pretty special, and it, you know, it showed what we came here to do, and we were acting as a team out there. So yeah, everything went to plan, man.
All right, what was the highlight of your day? What was a moment when you were out there, you're like, yeah, this is pretty good?
Today, I would have to say the second moto start. You know, coming out of the gate, I didn't see anyone. And I was like, you know, I'm racing 450, so these guys are going to be coming through this first turn whether I like it or not. So to get the jump like that, the second moto, it was riding around in fourth. That was, I was able to pace the leaders, and it was fun. I was off the back of them, so I wasn't getting too much roost, and I could kind of just pace off them, and I knew I was in a good spot for the team. So, yeah, P4 in the second moto was awesome.
Okay. Big weekend, dude. Qualifying moto win yesterday, yeah. MX2 overall winner today. That's a nice statement after the ups and downs of the year that we've talked about so many times.
Yeah, people weren't giving me a break this year. Coming off a bad injury, it was a little bit slow getting started. And then right when I started to turn things around, I got COVID after Unadilla. So that kind of wiped me out for the last few races. And Actually, right after the last race, when I went back to train, start riding again, I felt like I had my energy back, and that was, that was a breath of fresh air for me, and just really put my head down since then the last 3 weeks, and felt really good coming into this race. I think it would have been a little bit better if it didn't rain, but yeah, we were dealt with some European conditions probably, so it was tough but fun.
All right, you did Assen in 19. You're very good that year, but it's been a long 3 years since then. We always wonder how much does a race like that weigh on a guy's head. How much have you thought about it these last 2 years, and how nice is today after that to kind of put it to rest?
Yeah, honestly, like just being straight up honest, I didn't know if I wanted to do this event again because I didn't want to do something like that again. So it takes a lot of courage to kind of think about that for 3 years and go back after this. And especially on the 250, where a lot of things can happen. Like you had a big disadvantage and you have a lot more chance of getting into some chaos. So especially when the conditions are like this, raining, it was definitely a nerve-wracking day. And it was a tough one, but we bounced back from Assen the way we wanted to. And now we're leaving with MX2 overall. And of course the team, it's a big deal for us.
All right, very last thing. This could be your last race for a little bit. We know you got a couple things you can work on here or there to make it happen, but it has to feel pretty good to go out like this and know there's no questioning how you are on a 250 right now.
Yeah, I really haven't been thinking about next year. I've been thinking about this race. So now that we've won this race, brought it back to Team USA and home soil, I can kind of let the rest fall into place, you know? I feel like I did my job and I proved why I was picked. So. Yeah, the things are going to fall where they're going to fall. I'm not going to rush anything. We'll see what happens, but I'm sure I'll be in good hands with Stark.
Today was, for me, was a grind. I didn't feel super comfortable on the track, but was able to still be consistent and be on the podium, both motos, top three. So that was good for me when I'm not that comfortable, to be able to stay on the two wheels and get to the finish line for the team. And that was a big picture today. I obviously wanted to go for the win second moto, but just didn't want to rush anything and didn't want to be an idiot. So happy to get that done and get another, I guess, race that I haven't been in under the belt, and was stoked to be the first time on the team and to come out victorious was very cool.
Hey, as much as I hate to bring up yesterday, you know, it's okay. It's okay because you got it out of the way and everything went well. And I'm sure for you, you're like, I'm over it. We can get this done now. I got the one out of the way.
That one stung, I will say. That that fall was, it was dumb. The rut blew out and I just lost the front end. And I wish I could take it back, but obviously that's done and over with. So I wanted him to come in today and ride consistent was the biggest thing for me. I didn't want to be sketchy. I just wanted to be consistent on my lines and was able to do that. So stoked to kind of put that one behind us and was able to pull through today for the team.
As a fan, for like the last year, I've been really wanting to watch you and Maxim ride. Yeah. I think you guys have cool styles. I think the build's similar. How was that, especially to ride up against someone you've never raced before?
It was cool. It's a little bit different racing guys that I haven't raced. You don't know how they race, so it was cool being up there with them. I was trailing them for a while. I had some good lines, but like I said, it was just, I didn't want to make a dumb decision and lose, just wash and I guess throw the race away. So I feel like I was faster, but he rode really well and Team France was tough today. So congrats to him, and it was cool to race. I think him and I are pretty similar in age, and it was cool to race somebody that I haven't raced before.
Okay, you know, dream weekend, your birthday weekend, home race, all that. Dude, I think you've probably daydreamed about coming over that finish line like that your whole life. How did it feel to finally do that and to like let out that rev and scream and all that?
It was cool. That was highlight of the weekend right there. Aside from like the parade on Friday, coming over the finish line, especially being the first Team USA over the finish line and kind of getting those that crowd off the defense and having the cameras in your face, and then Eli coming off the track, giving him a hug, and it was just something that I never even really dreamed of, honestly. So was happy to do that, and like I said, I couldn't be more stoked for this team and to finally end the drought, and hopefully we can win next year, and hopefully I'm on the team and we can win in France. That's the goal.
Hey, congrats on your year, buddy.
Thank you. I'm glad I got this. I didn't win the overall in the MX3 today like I wanted to, but you know, we won as a team, and I'm motivated for next year's Supercross. That the outdoor series, it stung a little bit to come up short, but I learned a lot this year, and my riding's in a different spot than I've ever been in before. So looking forward to Supercross, and hopefully we can get Eli this time.